This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. I have another exciting episode for you today. Today we're at the Chicago ORD or O'Hare Airport. You can see the busy people running around trying to catch their flight. And actually, I got to go catch my flight real soon. But what we're here today to show you guys is something real cool that's happening and growing on at the airport. And here it is. This is the Chicago Department of Aviation O'Hare Urban Garden. So this is a picture of it, and there's a little description of it, but it's a urban garden here between terminals 2 and 3 inside the security area. And there's a little map, and that's where I'm headed right now so that we could check out and learn more about this urban garden inside the airport. I mean, if they can grow it in the airport, they can grow anywhere. So let's head over there and check it out.
You can see all the people with luggage moving steadily to their gates. But above it all, you'll notice something real cool, and that's O'Hare Urban Garden that we're gonna check out in just a second.
The Chicago O'Hare Urban Garden is right behind me, and it's basically grown aeroponically vegetables actually that are used in the airport for travelers that are actually buying meals at some of the restaurants. That's pretty sustainable right there, growing it where you need it and having a fresher and higher quality and better tasting food as well. Now let's head over here and check it out.
In the garden area, besides the amazing plants growing, they have all these nice posters here. So it's the Chicago Department of Aviation Sustainability Initiatives. So it looks like the Chicago Department of Aviation, has a whole lot of programs going on. For example, actually they got apiary, or they got bees. And they got 33 beehives here at O'Hare Airport with approximately 1.3 million bees, and it's the largest apiary at any airport in the world. Now I encourage other airports to, put in apiaries and do more green and sustainable and grow some food. In addition, they got some vegetated roofs here at the Chicago airport, although they're not edible. They also do recycling and sustainable construction practices. In addition, they use some clean air vehicles, and they have a water and energy management to reduce the water runoff and to reuse the water. And of course they got the O'Hare Urban Garden here, which is using the tower garden system that uses green technologies that recycle earth minerals and water. So O'Hare Urban Garden uses as little as 5% of the water used in conventional and organic farming. And here's another sign on the O'Hare Urban Garden. This garden contains over 1,100 plants and utilizes a very small footprint. And of course, here it says this was a collaborative project between Chicago Department of Aviation and HMS Host Corporation to develop a cutting-edge, environmentally friendly 928-square-foot aeroponic garden in the mezzanine level of the ORD Rotunda building. So check it out. This is really cool. The O'Hare Urban Garden will supply fresh-grown produce to O'Hare restaurants located a short walk away inside the terminals, such as Wicker Park, Wolfgang Puck, Stephanie's Tuscany, Torto's Frontiera by Rick Bayless, and Stanley's Kitchen and Tap. So next, the moment you've been waiting for, let's turn around and check out this aeroponic system they got growing. And man, they have a wide variety of crops growing on. Right over there, looks like they got some basil growing. And each one of these towers is, this is basically an aeroponic system, which is fairly similar to a hydroponic system. They're using a nutrient solution, but most of the time the roots get to have air and not the fertilizers. And each one of these towers, man, they're like, geez, I don't know, pushing 10 feet tall with the base. There's basically a large base, kind of looks like a half wine barrel, about that approximate size. And then they got a tower in here. Now the tower has 44 plants, each ring. As you can see, there's a ring there, has four spots. And they rotate each ring to have them offset from the one below it so things can grow out nicely. Actually, right there, we're looking at some arugula. Let's talk about the lighting there. Up above the lighting, you hear the classic hum of the HPS or high pressure sodium lighting. And man, this is one lit up place. About the only thing I can say is that I wish the energy that was driving these lights was coming from a renewable resource, such as solar panels on the roof, because we are here at, 6 a.m. in the morning, totally dark outside, and it's actually totally lit up in here. And I know the HPS lights, they take some money to run, and I don't know if it's, from a financial standpoint, aside from being real cool, I don't know if it's really super viable to be growing this much stuff under lights. And if they were, I'd probably packing a whole bunch of more of these guys to grow a lot more food. So there's about 44 plants on each tower here, all the way up. This one's arugula. This one, they just started planting lettuce, red, butterhead. Over there, they have some leaf parsley. Over here, they have some basil, and all these plants look absolutely amazing. Some onion chives, and here's some red tomatoes. If we look closely in there, I see some ripe tomatoes back there. I don't know if you guys can see those. I can barely reach in. I can't even get them. So it's just out of reach of all the railing here. Over in this one, looks like they planted some edible flowers. There's some gourmet lettuce, and man, this stuff looks real good. And let's see, some cilantro as well. And how this system is run is through a nutrient solution. And here's their nutrient solutions in some big 55, 60 gallon drums here that they use a pump system with some kind of filtration to basically water and provide the nutrients to all the plants. And this system is by Future Growing LLC. You can learn more about them at futuregrowing.com. Over in this area, it looks like they have the seed starting area. So this is pretty amazing. They're actually starting the seeds and the plants that are actually gonna go in to the tower gardens. And it looks like they are growing those in rock wool. So they're just using the standard rock wool and seeding in the rock wool. And these are like kind of like flood tables. They're just gonna basically water it. The water is gonna run down the table, get absorbed in the rock wool, and then kind of run out the other side through the little drain. And it looks like they're growing their starts here. So probably they're growing like, you know, one little area right there is 44 plants, enough to fill the whole tower. And this looks like it is on a continual cycling system. And the cycling system is they'll just keep harvesting and they'll keep planting new stuff as needed. In this one, they have jalapeno peppers, and there's some oregano. Oh, this one's really interesting. Never seen this one done before in aeroponics or hydroponics. Scarlet runner beans. All right. So they even grow heirlooms here at the Chicago airport. And who said you couldn't grow runner beans without a trellis? I don't know. We'll see how these guys get when they get a lot larger. Definitely going to be interesting. The oregano, looks like the oregano is doing amazingly well. I think you'd probably keep clipping off that and have tons of food. The sage, and in general, you know, some of these herbs or herb type plants are actually doing quite well. Green basil, cilantro, colored Swiss chard, looks like a rainbow mix. Purple basil, so looking a little bit anemic there, not quite as good as the green basil around the other side. And of course, some edible flowers. So these are edible Viola flowers. I often preach about the edible flowers and the violas, and also things like pansies are edible. Now it's a good opportunity. We're going to have some people that actually are coming to admire the garden, and we're going to interview them to see what their thoughts are on this awesome urban garden here at Chicago Airport. We're here with some fellow travelers today, and how did you guys come upon this garden?
We were deciding to explore the airport, and then we saw Caroline actually spotted like the sign saying Urban Garden, so we decided to come check it out.
Cool, and what do you guys think of this?
It's really cool.
We thought it was very unique and a really cool idea how it supplies like food and stuff for the restaurants nearby.
Awesome. So do you think other airports should do something like this and grow some food also?
Yeah, I think so.
How about even like your local shopping malls? Think that'd be cool to have something like this there to feed people in the food court?
Definitely.
All right, awesome. And so do you guys eat a lot of locally grown food, or, you know, a lot of fruits and vegetables, or do you guys eat a lot of, like, go to McDonald's a lot, or what? How's that?
Combination of both, I think.
Yeah, I'm really into teaching people about where food comes from, and, you know, food comes from the ground. Not necessarily aeroponic systems like this, but any food that you can grow is definitely a good thing. So do you have any last comments on the gardens here at Chicago Airport for my viewers? All right, great. Thank you so much. So I know you're thinking you might want to get some of these towers yourselves. And if you want to do that, you can get them from the company that makes them. And it's mytowergarden.com. And it's a tower garden, grow with it, and has a U.S. patent. And check it out, made in the USA. So definitely, this is really cool. So I hope to come back in the future and see this garden continuing to grow. Next, actually, I'm going to go ahead and sit down and give you my thoughts on this garden here at Chicago Airport.
I definitely thought that this urban garden here in the airport is definitely really cool. They're growing lots of stuff and they're getting people familiar with, you know, food and how it can be grown. And I think that's an amazing job right there. And they have a lot of sustainability, probably many more than most airports around the country. And I believe that other airports, but not only airports, even shopping malls and other places should have green initiatives to start conserving resources and even grow more food wherever they're at. This is one example of a project that is up and coming. It makes a nice, actually, artistic art piece and, you know, curiosity for people passing by, but also for us hardcore growers. It's really cool to see that, you know, there are other people that are concerned about the current U.S. food supply and want to increase the quality of the food by growing it yourself and making it more local. And when you grow it yourself, it also tastes much better and is also much fresher, and there's less inputs to grow the food on site than having it literally shipped across the country, you know, in the winter time when you could grow lettuce inside, you know, in the heated areas here in Chicago or most other places in the world. So I hope you enjoyed this episode learning more about the Chicago Urban Garden at the airport. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time and keep on growing.